Welcome back to STLTV Live. Terry Suri, the president of Critical Mass for the Visual Arts, is still with me. And now joining me is another part of their team, and it's Emily Haymeyer. Hey, Emily.
Hi.
So we heard a lot about what you guys do. You have such rich history in the St. Louis area. The arts in the St. Louis area have grown tremendously within the last 17 years. Yeah. And now you have a great event coming up. Can you tell us about the event, Emily?
Yeah. This Friday, we have an event called Homegrown for the Arts. And it's going to be on Cherokee Street, and it's a chicken coop design competition. So we're really excited for that. There'll also be an art auction, a local goods auction, and a lot of opportunities to see local music and to dance a little bit. Should be a whole lot of fun.
Great. Now tell us about the chicken coop design contest.
Well, St. Louis is one of the few cities in the country that allows chickens within city limits. So we thought that taking this idea would promote sustainability within the city and also kind of highlight that as one of the aspects of St. Louis that's unique and fun, and give artists an opportunity to try sculpture in a new light.
Great. Now, I didn't know about that. did you know about that? You have a chicken coop, huh?
I do have a chicken coop.
So what inspired you to get a chicken coop?
I don't know. It's nice to get eggs every morning. Chickens are relatively low maintenance pets. And it's nice to have some little guys in the backyard.
Yeah. So was it your idea to have this chicken coop design?
It was actually my neighbor's. So I live in a four family, and everybody in the four family thought it would be a good idea to do that. So a lot of times I found that it's one of those things that, you know, maybe neighbors would be excited about as opposed to unexcited.
Now you had several contestants and narrowed it down to four. What are some of the things that you're looking for when judging the contest?
So one of the most important things is that the coop is habitable for the animals, so that their feeding, watering is separate from the place where they might use the restroom, and that there's adequate space for them to run around. So there's like kind of an opening for them, for that to extend into a yard or into a chicken run. So the chicken is definitely a part of the criteria when we got the judges together. And then another aspect is ingenuity, so that it's interesting, interesting as a structure, but also that it serves as a chicken coop.
Great. Now we have some pictures here. Can you tell us a little bit about some of these pictures?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, this is Larry Rubling. This is Unclucky. And he is a punster, and he sent this in. We loved it simply because of the joke about the tornado tipping over the house.
Wow.
And that is exactly how it's going to look.
You've seen the coop, and it looks like
I haven't seen it. I've seen it in works, and that's what we're going to get from
Great.
That.
These coops seem pretty interesting. Tell us about this one.
Well, this was the other one that Larry submitted, and we had to pick between the two. So we went with Unclucky, but this was his Red Island, you know, road version. And it's just a box with a train. And what we liked about it was this pure whimsy and the dedication to really high craft and making this as pleasing as possible.
Right. Now here's another one.
This is very kind of a straightforward, practical one, but what we like about it is that it's a vertical design. Often when you think about the coop, it's a landscape, and this is a vertical design with perches that go out.
It's like a sky ride.
Yeah, exactly. very appropriate for an urban setting.
Yes. And
this is, of course, just another look at the same plan, and that image is a dummy of it. This is a rough dummy we are hoping.
So what are they constructed out of many of the chicken coops? Is it wood or?
Well, we have a donator, Refab. Eric Schwartz was one of our judges, and he donated a shopping spree for each of the chicken coop designers.
Great.
So they got to go to Refab and select from the materials that were there.
Very cool. So what are you looking forward to most about the event?
I'm excited to see a wide range of community members come out and have a lot of fun. You know, I think that this is kind of a whimsical, exciting way to celebrate sustainability.
Yeah.
What's St. Louis? You know, what's great about the city? Local businesses, local musicians. Yeah, I think it'll be a lot of fun.
And tell us the details about it again for our viewers.
So the date is October 18th, mm-hmm. Which is this Friday. And you can purchase tickets at the Critical Mass for the Arts website. If you get tickets in advance, it's $12 at the door, $15. Mm-hmm. Accelerando is going to be playing, Amu Amu. We have several DJs, and Sarah Paulson, who is a former Critical Mass Award recipient, will be sharing animations.
All right. Well, thank you guys for being here with me today. Best of luck and best wishes to you and your event. Coming up, you guys want to get tickets for the Homegrown event on October 18th to see who wins the Urban Chicken Coop Design Showdown. You don't want to miss it. Next up on STL TV Live, there are some great deals to be had in St. Louis, and this month you can shop for calls. Emily Zimmerman from St. Louis Premium Outlets will be here to tell us all about it. Stay tuned.